Once upon a time, in West Java, there lived a wise king who had a beautiful daughter. Her name was Dayang Sumbi. She liked weaving very much. One day, she was weaving a cloth. Suddenly, one of her tools fell to the ground. She was very tired at the time, so she was too lazy to take it. Then she shouted out loudly, "Anybody there? Bring me my tool. I will give you a special present. If you are female, I will consider you as my sister. If you are male, I will marry you." Suddenly, a male dog named Tumang came. He broke her felling tool. Dayang Sumbi was very surprised. She regret her word, but she called the net deny it. So she had to marry Tumang and leave her father. Then they live in small village. Several months later, they had a son. His name was Sangkuriang. He was a handsome and healthy boy. Sangkuriang liked hunting very much. He often went hunting to the wood using his arrow. When he went hunting, Tumang always with him. One day, Dayang Sumbi want to eat deer's heart. "Sangkuriang, will you hunt for a deer today? I want to eat a deer heart so much," asked Dayang Sumbi. "Of course, Mom. Whatever you want, I will give it for you," replied Sangkuriang. "Tumang, where are you? Come on, we have to hunt a deer." Then Sangkuriang went to the wood with his arrow and his faithful dog Tumang. But after several days in the wood, Sangkuriang couldn't find any deer. They were all disappeared. Sangkuriang was exhausted and desperate. "Oh God, where can I find a deer? I don't want to disappoint my mom." "Oh, I know." Sangkuriang then called Tumang and killed him. He didn't know what that Tumang was his father. At home, he gave Tumang's heart to her mother. "Sangkuriang, are you sure it's a deer's heart? You can't lie to me. It's Tumang's heart, isn't it? Why did you kill him?" said Dayang Sumbi, full of anger. She hit Sangkuriang at his head. Sangkuriang was wounded. There was a scar in his head. She also rebuilt her soon. Sangkuriang left her mother in sadness. Many years passed and Sangkuriang became a strong young man. He wandered everywhere. One day, he arrived at his own village, but he didn't realize it. There he met Dayang Sumbi. At the time, Dayang Sumbi was given an eternal beauty by God, so she stayed young forever. But of them didn't know each other, so they fall in love and then they decide to marry. But then Dayang Sumbi recognized a scar on Sangkuriang's head. "Sangkuriang, why there is a scar on your head?" asked Dayang Sumbi. "Oh, when I was a child, my mom hit me on my head," replied him. Dayang Sumbi was very shocked. She knew that Sangkuriang was his son. It was impossible for them to marry. She told him, but he did not believe her. Sangkuriang wished that they married soon. So, Dayang Sumbi gave him a very difficult condition. Sang Koryang, if you want to marry me, I have a condition for you. I want you to take a boiled egg and a big boat in one night. I need them for our honeymoon. Can you do that? Impossible. But it's okay. For you, I will do it. I can do that. Sang Koryang agreed. With the help of genies and spirits, Sang Koryang tried to build them. By midnight, he had finished the lake by building a dam in Citarum River. Then he started building the boat. It was almost done when he nearly finished it. Meanwhile, Dayang Sumbi kept watching on them. She was very worried. When she knew this, so she made legs in the eats. Troops, stop your work. It's already down. The sun will start to rise. Quickly, go home, go home, said the chair of Chinese. They left Sang Koryang alone. Sang Koryang, you can't finish my conditions. It means that you can marry me. You know, said Dayang Sumbi. You cheat! You make the light so that my troops go. Because of that, I couldn't fulfill your condition. So Sang Koryang. Sang Koryang was very angry. So he kicked the boat. Then the boat turned out to be the Mount Tangkuban Perahu.